Welcome back into the Nebraska Furniture Mart Locker Room Show, where I am now joined by Neil Jones and Jared Kohler for tonight's roundtable. This past week, other sports have followed NASCAR's lead, with big stars finding new areas of entertainment for fans to watch. Tyreek Hill, Tyrann Mathieu dueling it out on Madden. You had Michael Porter Jr. on ESPN playing NBA 2K. Travis Kelce even competed in a beer pong tournament. And now, reports of a horse competition featuring NBA stars on ESPN could potentially be coming to fruition. Are these helping fill the sports void at all for you guys, Jared?
Well, listen, I'm not exactly on the edge of my seat for all of this, but I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm tuned in, I'm at least watching, because guess what? I don't know the end of this. It doesn't matter how many times I rewatch Game 7 of the 2014 World Series. Alex Gordon is stopping at third base every single time. That ain't changing. But when Michael Porter Jr. is on 2K or Tyreek Hill's playing Madden, I don't know how that game's going to end. It's some fun banter, because you got to remember, these athletes are super competitive, not just on the floor, not just on the field. Everything they do, it's a competitive lifestyle for these guys, and when they're going at it, it is a little bit entertaining to watch. I'm not going to act like I'd spend 5 hours a day doing it, but it is fun to just tune in, see what your favorite athletes are up to.
Neil, you like this stuff?
No, it's okay, because there's nothing else to watch. It's a little bit like, you know, when you play Monopoly with your kids. Monopoly's not the greatest game of all time, but it's something to do when you're stuck inside with little kids, right? So I'm okay with it. And you know what? If people are having fun with it, then it's great.
Yeah, guys, I think that it's fun from the perspective that it gives these different sports kind of a different platform, especially when it comes to NASCAR. But I really love the fact that you kind of get to know these athletes a little bit better. It's not necessarily that you're getting to watch them compete or how they react or what's going to happen, but you got to know Travis Kelce during the beer pong tournament because he was just at his house playing beer pong. You got to meet his girlfriend and get to know her a little bit better because of how they were interacting with each other and with the opponent. Tyrann Mathieu threw up his arms and decided that he was going to be upset with Tyreek Hill because of how he was treating him on Madden. He's like, no, I'm too competitive. I'm not handling this right now. Not dealing with unsportsmanlike conduct on a Madden game. So you get to see kind of the best and worst sides of these athletes, but you also get to know them a little bit better. And we're definitely getting a chance to do that with Clint Bowyer and the stuff that you saw earlier in the show. I mean, we knew as media members that he is thoroughly entertaining and he is a blast to chat with, but now the public is getting a chance to see that too. So that's why I kind of like this stuff. Due to the coronavirus pandemic, college football season could be in jeopardy or at least potentially get pushed back many months. How weird would it be to see college football with no fans or played at the same time as potentially college basketball? Neil?
This is the best news that I heard all week, and I'm serious about that. When they say, look, if we have to play this thing second semester, we're going to do it, that's great news. They're doing it for financial reasons, because football drives the entire college football, or pardon me, college athletic universe. But the fact is, the fact that we know that there's going to be a season, even if it's not a full season, but if it's just a conference season, and then the playoffs, I love it. I think that gives us something to look forward to, because hopefully, even if it starts in December or January, we'll have some football.
Yeah. Jared?
Listen, if you thought March Madness was mad beforehand, imagine Kansas basketball going for a Big 12 title and Kansas State football going for a Big 12 title at the same day, maybe on the same Saturday. Just crazy. The sad part is, you know, they may not get the attention that they deserve if they're having to compete with each other with so many sports at the same time. But think about it from a fan perspective. If you've got all this great college football and college basketball at the very same time, you're just going to be staying on the couch. You're going to be wishing you were quarantined with the amount of great athletes on display.
Look, guys, I like it from the perspective that you know there's going to be a football season. But I do not like it from the perspective that you're going to have so much going on at the exact same time. Hang on. Not only will college football and college basketball be going on at the same time, but so will the NFL. Because if college football gets pushed back, NFL is going to get pushed back. Maybe fans, maybe no fans. We don't know. But then you're going to lump all of these sports all together at the same time. You're not going to know what to watch. We're not going to know what to cover. And it's going to be mass chaos and hysteria. Yes, it's great for fans. Yes, it's great for sports athletes who get a chance to play their season, but guys, that is a lot of coverage from us. So, as the sports director here at KCTV5 and having to deal and plan with all of that, not a big fan.
Listen, if you miss something, you just tune into the Locker Room Show, and we'll have it all right there. That sounds like a great idea.
That's a perfect plan. 30 minutes of plenty of content. See, this is why we got you around, because you're a thinker like that. Okay, a lot of people are actually pushing back on how many local golf courses and parks are packed during this pandemic. And I mean, it's been beautiful outside the last couple of days here in Kansas City. A ton of people out and about. But I do want to get your thoughts. Jared, let's start with you.
Well, listen, you're probably more likely to find me on a mini golf course than a real golf course, if we're being totally honest. With that said, safety is number one. I think people have to be careful, maybe even more careful than they are right now, because this is a serious deal. However, you can't expect people to be trapped inside their houses, okay? Sunlight, it's good for the soul. Get outside, go for a walk, go fishing, go golfing, as long as you are staying safe. And that's where you have to walk a very thin line. And I get that's where people have complaints, but as long as you're staying in the guidelines and staying safe, it's okay to get outside.
Neil, you and I were having this conversation before the show. What are your thoughts on this?
This is a big deal because I understand people are frustrated. I'm not allowed to go to work. I'm not allowed to go to restaurants. I can't take my family out to this. We can't do that. Why do they get to play golf? Why are parks open? Why are tennis courts and basketball courts being used? Look, if you are smart, like Jared said, and follow the rules, it is one of the safest things you can do. I played on Thursday. I walked. I didn't get near the two guys I was playing with. They were in carts. Or one of them was in a cart and he stayed where he was. The other guy walked. We all kept our distance. It was the safest I have felt during this whole thing because I was out in the middle of a park having a great time. I didn't touch anything. It was a blast.
I have a simple opinion on this. I love it. Any opportunity to be able to get outside and to be active is a plus for me. So I think that as long as you're smart, and I agree with both of you guys, enjoy yourselves. It's a hard time to really enjoy yourselves right now. And if getting outside, playing golf, going to a park is what makes you happy, then you need to be able to embrace that.